the Ugly. The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly was directed by Sergio Leone. To be honest, I couldn't pick a favorite movie. Like, all the movies are very different, and yeah, they're very different, different genres, different types of movies, different feels to the movies. The reason I picked this movie was for two reasons, or technically three reasons. One, I liked the movie. You know, would make sense. Number two, there we go. Notification. We love those. Number two is because it would be fun to film for. Because it would be like, I don't know, same reason I picked Vertigo last time. Vertigo has all the colors, so it's like a funner production. With the good, the bad, and the ugly, you know, it's Western, so, you know, whatever I'm wearing right now. And the third and final reason is because I'd never seen, like, a true Western before. I saw Blazing Saddles, but I didn't think that really counted. It wasn't, like, a classic Western type of thing. It's Mel Brooks. and so, you know, it was cool. It was so cool for me to watch a Clint Eastwood Western. I was watching it thinking, like, I'm watching history. I'm watching what everyone talks about. I'm watching something famous. Like, I felt that with certain movies, like Casablanca. I was like, I'm watching something famous. And I felt that with, you know, with The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly, with Clint Eastwood and everything. And I don't know, it was fun to watch and cool to be like, hey, I'm watching a Western. Like, you know, it's real, I guess. Fun fact, not the fun fact for the video, but to tie one of these, you have to wrap it around your face first, or else it won't stay in formation. And I guess I can't put it back on my face. But I had to learn how to tie a bandana for this. So, yeah. I guess I haven't tied many bandanas before. I kind of got it. But it looks really weird like that, so I'm just gonna... There we go. I honestly didn't expect to like this movie as much as I did, and I said that with Vertigo too, and it's the truth. I didn't really, it's funny that I'm choosing two movies that I didn't expect to like and ended up liking, just because I thought it would be like, I don't know, I knew it would be fun to watch, but I didn't think I'd like be like, oh, what's gonna happen, you know? But I guess, like, my main draw to the movie, and the reason I liked it so much, is I had never seen Clint Eastwood act before. And not only was it fun to watch in that regard, but he's a good actor. Like, I didn't think he would be as good as an actor as people said he was. I thought he was, like, famous, you know, for doing this thing. But that doesn't necessarily mean that it makes someone good. And I remember when we watched it being surprised at how good his acting was in the film. And even though Clint Eastwood's Blondie was my favorite character, I loved Tuco. First of all, I was very glad that Blondie didn't leave him at the end and that he lived. But yeah, he's just like a funny character, good actor. He's Eli Wallach. Yeah, he was great. It is brown face, because he is a white Jew, and not a Mexican man, but you know what, different time, so I'm just gonna be like, you know what, he did a great performance, I'm not gonna think about that too much, you know, I'm a white Jew, I'm not gonna be playing a Mexican anytime soon, definitely not painting my face, but the guy did good, and so he did good. My favorite line in the movie is actually said by Tuco, and it's when he's taking a bath, and that guy with the one arm comes in, and he's like, I learned how to shoot with my left hand, and I've been waiting for you for months, and he just, like, shoots the guy, and is like, when you have to shoot, shoot, don't talk. And I actually, when looking up, because I couldn't remember, like, the exact line, so I had to look it up, and when I was looking it up, I learned that was actually improvised. By Wallach, like, and everyone thought it was hilarious, so they used it, and, It's just because it's what we all think. You know, whenever we're saying there, like, those movies, and they're like, and this is my evil plot. We're like, dude, you're terrible. Like, just shoot the guy. Shoot the guy. Like, the longer you talk, the more time he has to escape. Like, so when he said that, I was like, thank you. Like, we were all thinking it. But knowing that it's improvised actually makes the line even better. Not just because I love improvised lines that end up in film. I love when that happens. Like, I love you, I know, you know? It's also because that means that, you know how we're all like, oh, that's what we're all thinking. Yeah, that's what Wallach was thinking too. That's why I said it. So, yeah, I like that. There are so many good scenes in this movie because it is a good movie. One of them, for me, one of my favorite scenes is that bathtub scene because it's just, you know, favorite line, right? But, my favorite scene was actually the almost, like, very last scene when Blondie leaves Tuco in the graveyard, like, hanging, and he's like, Blondie! And he's, like, trying to, like, get him, like, come back here! And I was like, no, he's not gonna leave him. No, and then he rides off, and I'm like, what? I was like, no. And then they keep panning back to the open plain, and once they did that, I was like, oh yeah, for sure, he's not leaving him, because what that's showing the audience is that we're supposed to be looking for him to come back. If he was, like, gone, they would have only showed it, like, twice, and then, you know, shown Tuco being upset or something or whatever, but or something or whatever. I'm making fun of myself, but no, they kept showing it over and over. So, based on, like, my knowledge of, like, how they film movies, I'm sitting there like, yeah, he's coming back. Like, even if, like, I thought for a second no, I was like, yeah, no, he's definitely coming back. And he did come back, and he did the whole, I can't even do it with two arms, but did the whole, you know, shot the and I was like, is he gonna shoot him? And then he shot the rope, and I was just like, yeah. And like, I don't know if he's that good. You know, it's supposed to be the good is Blondie, is Clint Eastwood. I don't know how good he is, but I guess that's showing that he's like the goodest. And that scene, the reason I like that scene so much is that scene shows that he is the good. Like, that's kind of like, I mean, a bunch of scenes obviously throughout the movie, but like, is he, you know, is he that good? Not really. But that scene is showing that he's the best of, you know, them, and he's the good. I also liked the dam scene. I don't remember it so much, because the scenes that I specifically was like, okay, I want to talk about this scene in the video, I went back and re-looked at those scenes so I could have it more fresh in my head. I did not look at the dam scene, like, when they're, like, in the water, like, blowing up the bridge and everything, or I guess not a dam, it's a bridge, or something, but, yeah, they're blowing up the bridge, or, it was, they're blowing up something, and that guy died. I don't remember it that well, but I remember liking, that whole sequence when they're, in that, like, military camp. Something I could improve upon, which I always think this question's so silly, what could have been better in the film? Like, I'm gonna critique a film, me, like, versus, like, famous people, yeah, but, I mean, kinda have to. So, there were some scenes that were, like, I think they were, like, making them longer for suspense, but it got to a certain point where I'm like, okay, the suspense is gone, now I'm waiting. Like, at first, I'm like, building suspense, getting there, having suspense, losing suspense, you know? Because I'm like, okay, it's getting a little too long. But that might just be because I'm raised with all this very fast things. Even though I do like a lot of the slower movies that we've watched in this class, but it's different when it's a fast scene and they're going slow, like a shootout. I'm like, shoot! You know? Like, what are you waiting for? And then, the other thing is that, like, there's, like, no backstory. The only person that really had a backstory was Tuco. He was, like, the most well-developed character. Blondie, Clint Eastwood's guy, or man with no name, he did, we don't really know much about him at all. Doesn't even have a name. Angel Eyes, I mean, we don't really get anything on him either. So I can't really connect with the characters because I don't know anything about the characters. They're very two-dimensional. There's no depth to them. Tuco has a little bit more depth because he has a little bit more background, but still, I mean, I guess it's not a character film about depth. It's about the plot, but still, you know, it's nice to kind of include both. And I found 3 fun facts, except they're not really fun. They're more deadly. They're more like deadly facts. Because Eli Wallach almost got seriously injured 3 times on set. I went to look up, actually was trying to look up fun facts about the director, because I was going to do, like, one about the director, one about the film, and then maybe, like, one more, right, that I can find. But instead, what came up was Eli Wallach, getting in these bad accidents and stuff. I was like, okay. But this is gonna be pretty, like, cut film, because I can't remember off the top of my head each of the 3. So, the first one is, in one of the scenes when Blondie is, like, shooting the rope, and so then Tuco falls onto the horse, and the horse takes off. In one of those scenes, he shot it, and he fell onto the horse, but the horse ran prematurely because it got scared of the noise. And so Eli Wallach wasn't actually safely secure on the horse, and he was, like, his hands were bound. So this horse is just running wild because it wasn't, like, what it was supposed to do. And it was just, he was just, like, tied and not, like, securely on the horse, which could have ended bad for him, but didn't. Number 2. I actually remember this scene happening, but then again, I saw the movie a while ago. So, apparently there's a scene where Tuco kills a Union soldier, and, something with a train, him getting on a train, him getting off a train, I'm not really sure, but apparently he put his head too high up, like Eli Wallach, put his head too high up than he was supposed to, and he almost got decapitated! So fun! Yeah, real life decapitation, that would have been great for, movie promotion, but, good thing he didn't. Number 3. In the cemetery, when they find the bags of gold, one of the bags of gold is, like, opened, you know? And, to make it easier to open, the crew put, like, whoever was in charge, put, like, acid, like, applied acid to the bag. And they were keeping the acid in a bottle that's, like, lemon soda bottle. And they, I guess they didn't tell anyone. And Wallach was just, like, thirsty and on set and decided to drink someone else's lemon soda and drink actual acid. Luckily, it burns like a, you know, mother. And, so he took a sip and was like, and spit it out everywhere because, you know, it's acid. And he was fine. So, yeah, can you imagine if he had fallen off that horse, gone a brain injury, or drink acid, or, you know, it's a miracle he survived. L'chaim. Overall, I really liked the movie. It's a classic. Definitely would watch it again. In fact, I kind of do want to watch it again because I don't remember a lot of it. I also want to watch other Clint Eastwood westerns and just westerns in general. Maybe then I'll learn how to tie bandanas a little better. But, yeah, I mean, we watched so many movies in that first half of the year, and they were all so good. And it feels so good when I'm sitting at a dinner table with adults having adult conversations, and I get a reference, and someone was talking about something, and they were like, oh, yeah, like how Stanley Kubrick faked the moon landing. And I was like, I know that one! You know? I was like, oh, my God, I got that! I got that! I was like, I I remember we learned about that. Or, like, just, like, random stuff. Like the other day, I was talking about old movies with my grandma, and I was saying I was watching old movies, you know? And she was talking about The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly. And I was like, oh, yeah, we watched that, you know? And then I got to tell her some interesting facts about it. I was like, yeah, I'm actually about to film a video about that tomorrow. So that was really, it's fun getting to participate in conversations like that, where I know stuff. I seem smarter. And, you know, with specifically Clint Eastwood, you know, I'll be watching a show, and they'll be like, oh yeah, my brother knows the line to every Clint Eastwood movie. And then he'll quote something, and I'm like, wait a minute, I recognize that quote. That was The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly. And I was like, oh my god, I got it. But yeah, I just love this class so much. I learned so much about movies, and I love analyzing film, and I love talking about movies. That's why these videos that I make are always so long, because I just ramble on. sorry. But yeah, so, thanks for watching, and, yeah. I filmed about 10 seconds of film, and it is already so bad. No. This is so bad. This arm is starting to hurt from, like, holding the camera. I'm, like, having to, like, support it. This is really showing how much exercise I get, that holding my almost weightless phone at a certain height for, I don't even know how long I've been doing this, not that long, already makes my arm hurt. Definitely need to, I don't know, do something active, lift weights. I don't know. I watch movies and TV shows. I don't exercise. I'll watch other people exercise, you know? You know, you do your whole diehard thing, crawling through vents and being all exercising and running. I'll stay here. I don't know why Die Hard's the first active movie that came to my mind. I was in my head like, what's an action film? Think fast. And Die Hard was the first one that came to my mind.